What's up, y'all? It's Demogini, and it's time for another one. So, today we're going to talk about one show that I used to watch, and I used to really love the show back in the day, and no judgment here. I liked the show. So, you know, whatever. You don't like it, who cares? But I, Buffy the Vampire Slayer. So, there's an article out from GameSpot.com, and it says, Buffy the Vampire Slayer being rebooted with Joss Whedon involved. And this is by Veronica Larkin. Listen, this is one of the things that seems to baffle my mind, is that for some reason, Hollywood in general seems to think that in order to revitalize something, you have to reboot it. Especially when you can always, especially with a show like Buffy, that the way it ended, Willow used her power to unlock all of the potential slayers and make them all slayers. So instead of just building off of that, and which, by the way, there is comics about what happened after, which was done by Joss Whedon, so technically speaking it should be canon, you know, if you want to throw the word canon in there. I mean, obviously with the comic you can get away with way more fantastical things. You know, obviously this is getting away with fantastical things anyway, because you're dealing with mysticism and magic and power and all that stuff. But you could have definitely built off of that. Rebooting it. The thing that annoys me is that even in this article it says, and I will have this in the description, it says that the cast really, they're still relatively young. I mean, people being in their late 30s, early 40s is still young. I mean, that's young. You know, you can still, I'm in my 40s, so it's just, it's whatever. I still feel like I'm 20. So you can still roll with a 40-year-old and have Buffy as a mentor. If you don't want to have Buffy as the main source, you can still have her as a mentor to the up-and-coming. Kind of like what they did with the Cobra Kai show, which I have not seen. I'm going to try to get around to see that. Because it basically revitalized the Karate Kid without having to reboot the Karate Kid, which they did a quote-unquote reboot with Jaden Smith, which was like, I mean, I watched it. It wasn't like it was, you know. Certain things you just really shouldn't touch. And by the way, the Buffy TV show was really not really an offshoot, but like kind of sort of a reboot of the movie. And even Christy Swanson still looks fantastic for, you know, she's up in her 40s too. So, you know, it's, you can still, if you wanted to go super crazy and have like, you know, a Buffy verse, you know, have like the original Buffy meet this Buffy or whatever, I don't know, something crazy you could do, because you're dealing with magic in different dimensions, you could do whatever you want. But the thing that gets me, which I'm going to scroll down here, because, like I said, we'll have this inside the description if you wanna read the whole article. It's not too long, but I don't like reading the whole thing anyway. So the last paragraph actually says, the producers reportedly intend to bring on an African American actor to play Buffy. Because, you know, everything has to be diverse now. That's one of the things they put in here. Buffy was/is a Valley Girl, you know. You don't have to throw a minority, quote unquote, you know, somebody of color, brown skin, any person to try to get in a new audience. The audience you have is the audience you have. Build off of what you have from there. Clearly, I'm not white, and I like that show. You don't have to sit there and try to throw, because what ends up happening is you throwing somebody, first off, doing a reboot is stupid anyway. But then doing a reboot and then saying Buffy's now black, it takes away from the story, because now people are like, that's not the Buffy I remember. And, you know, like it or not, that's just how things are. You know, for instance, Captain America, when Falcon took over to be Captain America, Bucky took over for being Captain America. Captain America is Steve Rogers. You know, now, sure, did you have somebody else get the super soldier serum? Sure. Have Steve Rogers be their mentor. Have Buffy Summers be the next mentor. You could have did a Frey the Vampire Slayer, which that's part of the canon too. That's part of the whole comic books. Frey's a little bit further in the future, but so what? You still could have did that. You know, I just think that when you're changing the characters, I mean, and perfect example, the WB's putting out Charmed coming up as a reboot of Charmed with the all brown girl cast. Nothing wrong with that, but again, it takes away from the people that you originally had. You know, if you're going to have... I never really watched Charmed. I knew what it was. I knew the concept. I watched a couple of episodes like that. I wasn't like a follower. Main reason I really started watching Buffy is because of Allison Hannigan, because she was really big with the whole American Pie thing back in the day, too. So that kind of drew me to that show to begin with. And but it takes away from the story. Again, like I said, you grew up watching this show and people were a certain way. Listen, I get it. You want to have a much more diverse cast and everything. That's fine. That's beautiful. Make original characters. You can keep it in the same universe. Just make original characters. It doesn't have to be, oh, this person is now black. Oh, what a shocker. Come on, that takes away from it. And like I said, I just think that if you're going to do it, and what makes it even worse is that you have the whole, like I said, you have the whole concept of all the potential slayers, now active slayers. They all have the power of a slayer. Wow. Could you go so many places with that? So many places. You know, like, yeah, you don't have to do copy and paste from comic books. I understand that. But you can still use them as guidelines. There has been a continuation of Buffy in the comics. Use that as guidelines. And you just keep on going. You could call it Buffy the Vampire Slayer Presents. I don't know. If you just want to keep that name to draw people in. Whatever you got to do. But I just think rebooting it in general is dumb. Rebooting it with a African-American woman is even dumber. You know, if you want to have a black slayer, Kendra was a black slayer. She was in Buffy the Vampire Slayer show. You could easily do that. I'm just saying. It's not like they didn't have a diverse bunch of people in it to begin with. And that just kills me when you say, oh, we have to be diverse now, when they already were diverse. It's ridiculous. So, how do you guys feel about that? Do you think that this is a good idea? I mean, I'm not fond of the whole rebooting scenario like I've been saying in here. But if they are going to try to revitalize, which we gotta kind of separate the two. If you want to revitalize a franchise, you don't have to reboot it and necessarily to get that, you know, shot in the arm again. You don't have to do that. So how do you guys feel about that? Let me know in the comments. Like, share, and subscribe, and I'll catch you guys later. Peace. Feelings of sadness, I'll take you there. It's like this kid, yo, I swear you can't touch me. Like vampires with no Buffy, it's no show. No contest, put it to rest, you're out of your